All right, in this video, we'll show you how you can collect GPS data with your Garmin Instinct. So normally with these GPS watches, everything's centered around activity profiles, walk, bike, paddle, that kind of stuff. And it will record a track. The track will have a bunch of points, but we can actually use the Instinct in a bunch of other different situations where we're collecting field data. So basically we have a couple of scenarios here. First, we can collect a single point of information. We can also collect a line, which is 2 points. And we can also collect information that will make up an area or a polygon. So I'm just gonna show just a couple ways that we can get around this very simply with the Garmin Instinct. First thing, let's go over to the single point. Obviously, there's two ways we can collect a point. We can collect the point where we are right here in our current location, or a point in another location. Let's say that we're hiking and we see a trail sign with a set of coordinates on it. So we wanna mark a waypoint somewhere else. So on the Instinct, it's very simple. All we have to do is press and hold the GPS button, and then we'll turn on the GPS screen. Now, you don't need to have an activity profile running when you're doing this, so you can just be manually creating these waypoints. You don't have to be doing a hike activity or run activity. Here we have our GPS coordinates. We can edit, log it, do what we want with it. So we're gonna press the save, for example. From here, we can edit, right? So that's one way to do it. The other way is to enter a set of coordinates that is not in our current or manually. So we might see it on the map, trail post sign, that kind of stuff. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna hit the GPS button to get our activity profiles. And down here from our favorites, we have a bunch of other manual features here. We're gonna go under navigate, and we're going to go down to coordinates. And this will allow us to manually enter coordinates. Now, bear in mind the format of coordinates matter. So if you see some coordinates that don't exactly match this type of formatting in terms of the number of digits and spaces and dots, that makes a difference. So you might see coordinates where there's a whole bunch of numbers together, which is probably UTM. You might see lat long, which is a whole different format. This is kind of like lat long decimal format, which you tend to see a little bit more often these days. So from here, all we can do is we can go in, and then we can go in and manually edit these coordinates, and now we have our location from another point. Now, which is why this is kind of important to be able to manually do, is because we want to be able to navigate in our second scenario from one point to another point, so from our current location to another location. Or if we're doing an activity, we have a whole bunch of points here. But let's focus on this one here first. So let's stay in our navigate. And what we want to do here is we want to navigate to a location. So we have our save location. So what we would do here is we can either go down and create a location that we want to navigate to. And once it's created, we can find it in our list and navigate to it. And then you can just do a simple navigation, right? You can choose which points you want and all that. The other feature, let's say if you want to do more map and compass style navigation, so let's say you're paddling and you reached a certain point, and the directions is you have to go down a specific compass bearing so that you can find the landing spot or a good fishing space or something like that. So this one, we have the sight and go feature that allows you to lock in your compass bearing to the direction. So we have one point here, we're gonna lock it into a compass bearing and go to another point. So for this one here, we're simply just rotate the watch to whatever compass bearing that we need to go to, press the GPS key, and then that kind of locks it in. Now we have kind of like a point A to B navigation, have our map screen, and now we can do it. All right, so the other option to do point A to point B is when you actually maybe know the distance. So for example, you can project a waypoint. This is very similar to point A to point B, as opposed to sight and go, where you can lock in the bearing. You're not quite sure how far you need to go. With project waypoint, you're setting the bearing and you're setting the distance so that you know exactly where it is. So project waypoint here, you can see we have our distance, we have our bearing, and then we can adjust the heading right here. And then we can navigate very similar to sight and go. And finally, when we're recording a polygon or an area, when we're doing an activity, we can probably do this ourselves and download our track to our computer and then calculate the area from our course that way. But Garmin has a feature called area. Again, this is manually. You can manually create this anytime you want. Again, on the Instinct, it's found here on area calculation. And all you can do here is you can select it, and then you can walk around the perimeter, or if you're paddling, for example, you want to measure a body of water, you know, fun stuff like that, you can do it like that, and you can measure it. And these features here will turn off after you've kind of done with them. So essentially, that is basically quick ways you can use the GPS to cover these types of GPS scenarios on the Garmin Instinct.